The Forever War is a 1974 science fiction novel by the American author Joe Haldeman. Haldeman served as a combat engineer in Vietnam, and his book draws on that. It won 3 major prizes shortly after its release, and nowadays it's regarded not just as one of the classics of the genre, but as a major novel in its own right. It's about an interstellar war between Earth and a mysterious race from the other side of the galaxy who get called the Taurans. The protagonists, a physics graduate called William Mandela, is recruited when the war begins, and he's among the last soldiers to return over 1,000 years later. At that point, he survived a handful of dangerous missions, and he's not much older than when he began. Time dilation, as described in the theory of relativity, explains how that's possible. Haldeman studied physics and astronomy at college, and his expertise is constantly evident. He also imagines a version of future physics which he blends seamlessly with real physics, and he avoids the dreaded info dump where too much exposition stalls the flow of the narrative. He does all that and more, which is partly what makes The Forever War such a great science fiction novel. But it's a great novel more generally. Yes, it's clearly a coded revisitation of the author's experiences in Vietnam, and equally of the estrangement soldiers often feel when they return to civilian life. But it's also a profound reflection on the process of growing old. What constitutes aging beyond the obvious biological effects? For the novel to address that question, it's crucial that Mandela, the protagonist, doesn't grow old in the conventional sense. Firstly, lived experience, specifically here Mandela's war weariness. In one way, he really is becoming older faster. He's seen things others haven't, and those things have changed him. They've estranged him from his colleagues. War here is arguably aging, accelerated and intensified. The second non-biological component of aging derives from the way people are enculturated by their upbringing, so that sooner or later their manner of relating to the world inevitably becomes outdated. Mandela's attitudes age, even his speech ages. Thirdly, there are the labels we apply to other people. In The Forever War, Mandela's gradual promotion to the ranks, from private to major, is a kind of symbolic ageing. Thanks to those socially sanctioned markers, the distance between him and each successive generation subtly increases. That's one reading. At least partly, it's about how there's no such thing as everlasting youth. Not in this universe, anyway. And by the way, it's also a love story. When you find out what that story is and how it links to the author's life, believe me, you'll find this cover quite moving.